What's good, YouTube? You already know it's Boring Dog. Come and catch another video, man. And before we start this video, man, I'm going to take 5 seconds. Go ahead and make that thumb button blue, man. All right, man. What's good, YouTube? You already know it's Boring Dog. Come and catch another video, man. And today, man, I know you guys enjoy the small forward content, man. I have figured out what you guys enjoy. I've been looking at the analytics and stuff. And I see that you guys really like my small forward content, man, because it's so much of an underrated build this year, and a lot of people don't make it. Everybody is just, you know what I'm saying, they just do what 2K tells them to do and make those type of builds, you know, offensive threats and stuff like that. But I know it's still a lot of y'all that come from 15 and 16, and you know, even 17 and 18 rather, but in my opinion, mostly 15 and 16 that missed that small forward all around type of build, you know what I'm saying, meta for the game and stuff like that. So today we are going to be getting into my top 5 things that you need to have in order to be the best all around small forward that you can possibly be after patch 10. Now, without further ado, y'all, we finna hop straight into it. Let's get it. So the first thing we have here, guys, is obviously number one most important Hall of Fame playmaking badges, guys. Yes, if you plan on dribbling and doing all of this being fast as a small forward, you're going to need Hall of Fame playmaking. So pick the pie chart that has a majority of playmaking, because it is obviously the most balanced. And you know what I'm saying, you're gonna get your Hall of Fame playmaking badges, because how do you expect to do anything without those Hall of Fame playmaking badges? Like, how do y'all expect to do anything without those Hall of Fame playmaking badges? You know what I'm saying? So obviously you want to have them on, because you need to be fast. You can't be running out there like a sloth. You can't be looking like a sloth out there and you already 6'9", man. You already slow as it is. You can't be a snail out there. So I ain't trying to hear none of these, you know what I'm saying, it's 3-level score vibes or nothing like that. No, we are trying to be a scoring point guard in a 6'9 body. For all my small forward brethren out there, you know what I'm saying? So we have to have Hall of Fame, you know what I'm saying, Hall of Fame playmaking badges. And the first, I'm gonna say the main three, man, you're gonna want to have for sure is Hall of Fame quick first step. Obviously you're gonna need quick first step, man, to pretty much, you know what I'm saying, speed boost, you know what I'm saying, just be real fast. If I say, you know what I'm saying, too much, I don't care, you know what I'm saying, I'm sorry, but at the same time, I don't care. But anyway, gonna need quick first step. It's gonna make you a lot faster, man. One thing I noticed, even on a point guard, y'all, I remember I had like a 6'5 offensive threat with gold quick first step, and I felt like my small forward was faster. So Hall of Fame playmaking is the wave. And then you obviously gonna want to have Hall of Fame quick first step. The next badge you're gonna want to have, without a doubt, is obviously gonna be handles for days. Self-explanatory. Reduces the amount of energy lost when performing dribble moves. Why wouldn't you want to have this badge? Because if you guys don't know, Mike Twain, you know what I'm saying, Mike One Time, whatever his name is, you know what I'm saying, he said when you lose energy, you lose attributes towards your dribbling. So what does that tell you? When you get tired and you start looking like you gotta have oxygen out there getting a Gatorade symbol, you're gonna lose attributes. So you're gonna be dribbling like, once again, a sloth. So definitely throw on this handles for days, my guys, if you want to be dribbling like a coat, you know what I'm saying? You can be out there looking like KD, you know, Paul George, you feel me? If, you know what I'm saying, you want to be looking like that, you know? Now that next badge is for my serious small forwards that like to actually create their own shot, not just the ones that just, you know what I'm saying, doing some simple quick first step type of stuff. The ones that actually want to make highlight real plays. The next one you're going to need is Hall of Fame Space Creator. And let me tell you guys something. After patch 10, Space Creator is the wave. Space Creator is better than Ankle Breaker and Tight Handles. Space Creator is a new badge to break ankles with, and obviously to create space with hop steps and things of that such. So you obviously gonna want to have that on. I'm telling you guys right now, Space Creator does it, you know, even for low ball handling builds. I only have like a 77 78 ball handling, and I, as y'all can see in my highlights and everything else, I break ankles easily. So now we finna hop straight into the second most important thing. The next thing you're gonna want is boost. Self-explanatory. You're gonna need ball handling boost because it increases, you know what I'm saying, your abilities, your handling and passing abilities, you know what I'm saying? And you're gonna need this bad because, you know, like, we already at a low, you know what I'm saying, ball handling rating as it is, you know, 70. Some of y'all might got 74s, you know. Some of us, like me, myself, got about a 77. So I'm gonna just say 75 through 78, you know what I'm saying? And you're definitely gonna need ball handling boost because without the ball handling boost, you won't perform as greatly as you could, you know what I'm saying, with them on. So definitely have these on, you know, and you know what I'm saying? Let's get into the next thing. The next thing you're gonna need is Gatorade. Yes. Now, guys, I'm sure you are all missing, you know, the 2K15-16 where you didn't have to buy no Gatorade, you know what I'm saying, to keep your lungs and your chest from falling and collapsing when you do an in and out, or when you do a little quick first step, you know what I'm saying, you be about to pass out looking for an asthma inhaler, you know, like you just, you know what I'm saying, you basically out of shape, you know what I'm saying, like you, they basically got in shape NBA players dribbling like how do I describe this, guys? I'm gonna just say this for instance, guys, just to sum up what I'm saying. The dribbling stamina has been so bad for the last 3 years from 17 that it almost makes you feel like as if you're Mark Henry size dribbling. It makes you feel like you're dribbling with Mark Henry, basically. And you guys know Mark Henry won't be able to do 2 dribble moves in real life without getting the Gatorade. So. But yeah, guys, it's pretty much pay to dribble, you know. So definitely go ahead and get you some Gatorade. Now, listen. I usually just get this one right here because of the simple fact, you know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to sit here and spend 35 racks 3 times, you know. Even though it is better to have all of these, but no. You can have a lot of VC and you'll try to spend all this extra stuff and, you know what I'm saying, just be spending $3,500. Man, you'll be broke by the end of the boost, you know what I'm saying? By the end of 2 sets of boost. So definitely just throw on the one right here, you know what I'm saying, that give you the extra bar energy. It gives you the extra bar energy so you can perform a little bit more dribble moves, you know? So pick this one right here. Now you're gonna hop straight into the third thing. Hopping straight into the fourth thing, I meant, my bad, you know? I lost track. Hopping to the fourth thing. Gym rat. Yes. You need gym rat. Guys, you definitely need gym rat, man. Gym rat will allow you to get not one, but 2 bars of Gatorade. And guys, if you're an ISO, I'm somebody, we just represent ISO, all you do is ISO, man, you know that those 2 bars are great. So you're gonna need those 2 bars. And then also another thing that you guys might not know, gym rat actually it actually gives you a +5. It actually gives you a better 5% chance of shooting a shot, I believe that's what he said. Yeah, it gives you a 5% chance, a better 5% chance. I've you said it, put it this way, it helps you make a shot. Simple. And I believe with 2 bars, it's a 10% chance that you will make a shot. So it's a 10% more chance that you will make a shot. You get what I'm saying, y'all. It increases your chance to make a shot. and it also helps you dribble better. And another thing that I might add, Gym Rat gives you +4 permanently, so you don't have to go back to the Gatorade station and work out, you know what I'm saying? You ain't got to do none of that no more. So, you know, it also gives you, you know what I'm saying? Well, y'all already said the +4, but speed and acceleration also plays a part, you know, in dribbling fast and being all around smart for it. So all you guys got to do, man, just get in my career, grind out, man. You ain't got to play every game, sim all the way to the end of the postseason. Then, you know, just play those 16 games. Go 16-0. And just get your gym rep, my guy. It's that simple. Just get your gym rep, my guy. If you want to be dribbling better, get your gym rep, my guy. Just go ahead and, you know what I'm saying, ice through the season. And go ahead and go 16-0 in the playoffs. And there you go. You got your gym rep. Now we're going to hop to the fifth and final thing. And the fifth and final thing that we are going to hop into is you have to have the right lineup, guys. So what I mean by that is you preferably want to be at center. No matter what the stipulations is, you're going to want to be at center at all times, whether it's 3v3 or 2v2. Now, Rick, in pro-am, you know, you can be, I say be power forward, you know, be power forward, something like that. But you're going to want to be center at all times, because reason why I say that is when you're on the center, you will always be the ultimate mismatch for the center. The center will constantly have to switch, because if you guys notice a lot in some of my gameplays with the well-rounded wing, the center always tends to tell the point guard to guard me, and that's when I just make the extra pass and, you know, get the green light before they can switch. But back to what I was saying is the center will always be slower than you. They won't be able to keep up with you, and it'll be hard for them to predict what you're going to do if you actually know what you're doing with the sticks, because they're going to be wondering, are you going to shoot once you start making shots? And then after you start green, you know what I'm saying, probably may have to make about 3 shots for them to just really step up. Then you'll just be able to make it in the paint all you want to, because you're going to blow by them every single time. So preferably, guys, I would prefer to have some like a lock at the point. And then, you know, at the two guard, you can have some like a, you can really have what you want, but I like the, you know what I'm saying, the all around lineup. So I prefer to have another small forward at the shooting guard, or you can have some like a big 6'6", 3-level score or something like that, because you're going to be the primary ball handler whenever the center is on you. Well, you're going to be the primary point guard, really, because the center has to guard you. So you guys get what I'm saying? That'd be, that's the perfect recipe, you know what I'm saying, to really showcase this build. So that's when you will see this build at its full potential, you know, because I ain't going to lie to you, I'm not going to sit here and lie like it's just easy to get past guards and stuff like that. But it is tough if you ain't got takeover. If you ain't got takeover, it's going to be tough to get past a guard. And that's just keeping it all the way a buck with you guys. So definitely take these tips into order, man. And I guarantee you, you guys will be the best small forward you can possibly be. You won't have as many problems with it. You'll learn to enjoy your small forward, man. You'll learn to enjoy lots of things about your small forward and everything. Because like I said, guys, you have to follow these 5 steps if you really want to, you know what I'm saying, be good as a small forward. Because it's tough this year for us, man. For all my Kevin Durant, LeBron James fans out there, Paul George fans, etc., etc., it's tough, my guys. It's tough. But guess what? They can't hold me down. 2K can't patch me. I'm going to always find the most goated small forward builds, guys. I promise you. I'm going to always find the most goated small forward builds. And I'm going to continue to drop the content for y'all, because I know a lot of y'all out there need this, man. Y'all need this because y'all want to be a small forward. I totally get the concept that you guys don't want to be short, you know, being a point guard and that stuff. I totally get it. I don't want to be short either on the game, because to tell you the truth, when you're short, you just feel like you're like 5 feet tall on this game. And just being short on this game just truly isn't fair. It truly isn't, because the point guard and center matchups, center duos will always abuse and mismatch with the screen, the pick and roll and stuff like that. And you just always get baby. So I definitely understand why you guys want to be big and still be able to do things. I definitely understand, guys. I remember all the good days of 15 and 16 where you could be big, you know. You could be 6 foot, 11, 6 foot 10, 6 foot 8, 6 foot 9, 7 foot, and do everything you wanted to do. Everybody had the same build. Everybody had fun. I remember that, y'all. But if you guys did enjoy the content, make sure you spam with the like button, like, share, subscribe, and I'm out, y'all.